strategies for you. This is the Lord's word for you. Hallelujah. Let me read it for you just once in our language. Amen. But I shall be named the priest of the Lord. I hope you know it is you. It is not me. But I shall be named the priest of the Lord. Shall call me the minister of our God. I will not eat the riches of my neighbor. I will go into the Gentile land and I will eat whatever it is they have put. Can I prophesy to you these 2 days that are remaining? I open the riches of the Gentiles up to you in the name of Jesus. Wealth must get from the Gentile hands to your hands. 100%. First, touch your neighbor. Say, you cannot fail to touch this. These 2 days, do something that you have not yet done. Do things that you have never thought of doing. Invoke the Lord. Touch something because the heavens are open over you. Money must come to you. Wealth must find you. Riches must find you. Can I hear someone celebrate Jesus? Hallelujah! The things that you have heard have been fulfilled in your life today. We're not talking about scripture. As a matter of fact, for all we care, we might not open that Bible because we are not reading scripture. We are the living scripture. We are the Bible. When I speak, I am not speaking because I read the scripture. I am speaking because the entire scripture is hidden and deposited on the inside of me. I speak out of the fullness of that word. The Bible says that Jesus met men, the Pharisees, and he said, the scripture that you are reading is written about me. That scripture, that entire scripture, everything it is telling you, it is speaking about it in terms of Prophet Dawn. So if the scripture says, rise, walk, touch someone, say, rise, take up your bed and walk. That word is being fulfilled in your life today, not tomorrow. Let me show you something. All of us, at the start, when we get born again, we start at the place where it says, seek first the kingdom of God. Yes. And he says, and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto. That is the starting point. It is not our end point. First touch someone. Say, it is the starting point. And he says in the book of Jeremiah, you will find me if you seek me with all your heart. That means there is a finding. We are not called to just seek the Lord. We are called to seek him and find him. Now, you have come to the place where men have found the Lord. We are no longer in the seeking. We are in the place where we have found. So if you have found the Lord, let me tell you how God rewards a man that has sought him. He does not reward you with things. He does not reward you materially. He rewards you with himself. That means when you start to walk, you are not walking on your own. You are not speaking on someone's behalf. You are speaking as himself. You are speaking as God himself. I hope you have seen this with the likes of Moses. I hope you have seen this with the likes of Elijah. I hope you have seen it with the likes of Elisha. Elisha speaks to a nation that is in famine, that is in lack, and he says, by this time tomorrow, he did not even stand up from his chair. He stays in his chair and said, gentlemen, by this time tomorrow, money will be flooding on your account. I don't know if I have a man in this house. Can I prophesy to you, if you have ears, by this time tomorrow, there will be money flowing on your account. There was an abundance where there was famine. Why? Because the word was shared. The thing that we are talking about, Pastor Joneba, say, the thing that we are talking about is the power in the spoken word, the power in the uttered word, the power that comes from a prophetic word. Why do we call it a word? You might get an entire sentence, but because it is the word of God, it is the word that creates, it is the word that powers you, it is the word that makes a way, it is the word. The reason it doesn't have a plural is that because it is God. It has no plural. The Bible says Isaiah 55, 11. And my word, he says, and my word shall not return to me void, but it will come back. Touch your neighbor, say, with a testimony. You will not get that word. It can be a bunch of words that are said unto you, right? It can be 1,000 words. The prophet can call you and say, you, this is the beginning, this is what is going to happen, this is what is going to happen, and it will happen in this time. But that entire discourse is called a word, because when you receive it, you have not merely received words, you have received God. He cannot be in plural. We have only one God. So when the word comes to you, you have essentially received God. Now touch your neighbor, say, you have 2 days. You have only 2 days. For some of us, we have tonight. I don't know if I am with some people. If he says you're going to be the next mayor, so be it. Do you hear me? Without skill, without experience, without qualification. Why? Because he owns this entire universe. He owns heaven and earth. That is the new way. God is trying to take us from the old way to the new way. There is a new way to doing things. The other thing, which is the last thing, touch your neighbor, say, this other way is quick. Touch your neighbor, say, this other way comes with speed. The minute that Jesus looked at the man was not even sure what it is he wanted. Jesus says, gentleman, rise up. Amina. Pick up your bed and do what? And walk. That looks like 3 levels, but it is actually 1 level. Because the minute the word comes, even if you are at your lowest, you are going to get to the top. There is no levels. That is a quick way. First, touch your neighbor, say, a speedy way. Some of you are seated here, but immediately your life is going to change. I meant immediately. Before I finish this ministration, for most of you that have understood what the Lord is trying to tell you, before I finish this ministration, I don't even have to say I prophesy. Before I finish, most of you will have received 100% tangible expression of the word that you are hearing. We are in this generation where we move from what is not even already expressed to us. Let me tell you something about this dispensation. We have already moved from this dispensation of what you call grace. We are in the dispensation of the age to come. Some people are still in that age, but for us, we are in that age that is to come. That is why we are able to tap on realities in the spiritual realm and bring them and make them visible in this natural world. This is your time. If God says there is only 2 days, just believe it. It is going to happen. I hear a suddenly happening in your life. They're going to see you here, and suddenly you will be in Dubai. I pray someone picks what I'm talking about. They will hear from you when you are saying, I'm going home to Jisasi. The next time they call you, you are going to be in another country. So be it in the name of Jesus. People are going to call you, and the last they heard of you, you had lost your job. The minute they call you again, you have more than enough. You are saying, I don't need the job. God has already taken care of me. Touch your neighbor, say, 2 days. Thing like this. Situations do not change by the power of prayer. I am going to teach you things. I've heard so many people say, push. Is it called push? What does it say? Pray until something happens. Thank you. That is the only thing. It is not, you have enough words, you are intercessor. What is your neighbor? Bobo yogera nyo, katia kama ya kuito kuba intercessor. No, it is not how many words you are saying. For some of us, you don't even talk, but you commune with the Lord. And the Lord gives you the answer before you even utter a word. That is true communion. You are speaking to your Father in heaven. That is why it says you are speaking to your Father who is in secret. He is on the inside. The people on the outside don't have to hear. Touch your neighbor, say, there is a level that doesn't know prayer. It doesn't mean that it puts prayer out of its place. And having an explained prayer, I hope you have understood what I'm talking about. This is your lifestyle. It is not something you do for an answer. No. Prayer, fasting. Now touch your neighbor, say, there is another level that raises the dead, that lifts men and puts them in the palace. There is a level. The Bible says that when there were dry bones in Israel, touch your neighbor, say, they called the prophet. Because the prophet he doesn't even know what he carries. He doesn't know that this vast army that is now dry bones, he has it in himself to bring it back to life. He didn't know. Because when God asked him, he said, you alone know. I have no idea. Until the Lord said, professor. Touch your neighbor, say, professor. Prophecy is a word, but that word is everything that you need to move from this place to the place that the Lord has spoken to you. Most of you are here, you might not have a job. I want you to hear me properly. Because the normal process has told you, you need a job to get rich. You need a job to parent. I don't know, but that is the natural process. But this prophecy I'm talking about, this word you are hearing today, has everything you need from now until the end of the month to bring wealth into your hands. It is enough. Can I prophesy? Someone lift your hands. Say, before this month ends, I've grabbed this word and it must manifest in my life in the name of Jesus. So be it to you and to your family in Jesus' name.